The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, second chapter, text number 1, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on December 7th, 1972, in Ahmedabad, India.
Asupurna kulekshanam visidantam idam vakam uvacha Madhusudana. Madhusudana, Krishna is described here as Madhusudana, the killer of the demon Madhu, Madhukaitava Bhara. So, Arjuna was attacked by a demon of forgetting his duty, being too much afflicted by bodily relations. This is our position in this material world. We are so much attached to this bodily relationship that it is to be considered just like we are ghostly haunted. In a poetry, Prem Vivarta, it is said that Pishachi paile jano motichanna hoy. Mayakasta jiver sei dasha upajat. Mayakasta jiv. Mayakasta maya means illusion, hallucinations. So, we are in this material world. We are all illusions. Illusion means accepting something as fact which is not. Something, just like in dream, we see sometimes I'm attacked with a tiger. My head is being cut off. So many things. So actually, there is no tiger. My head is not being cut off, but still I am crying. Oh, here is a tiger, here is a tiger. So, our attachment for this world is like that. It is illusion. I am thinking that without me, everything will be spoiled. My presence is required, and so on, so on. Just like sometimes our political leader, each and every one of them think that without him, the whole situation will be spoiled. Even Mahatma Gandhi, he was so attached that he would not retire from political life unless he was killed. The attachment was so strong. But after passing away of Mahatma Gandhi or Jawaharlal Nehru or so many big, big leaders, the world is going on. There is a Bengali proverb that when the king dies, it does not mean the kingdom stops. The kingdom goes on. But when so long the leader or the person in charge remains there, he thinks that without me everything will be spoiled. This is called maya. This is called illusion. According to Vedic system, therefore, there is forced renouncing. Nobody wants to return from family life, But the Vedic injunction is that after one has passed 50 years, he must leave his family. Panchasodham manam brajet. In the beginning, as a student life, he sena, brahmachari, undergoing severe austerities, penances, and taking instruction from the spiritual master about the temporary existence of this material world. In this way, he trained up very nicely. And even after training, if he appears to be attached to this material world, he is allowed to go home and marry. And some of the brahmacharis are allowed to remain noistic brahmachari without going home and accepting a wife. But one who cannot, he is allowed to accept wife and become a householder and remain there for 25 years, because generally the brahmachari was going home at the age of 24 years, 25 years. So after marriage, he may get a child. So living there for 25 years means the child is grown up. Then the husband and wife take leave, not living for good, but vanaprastha, traveling in pilgrimages like Vrindavan, Prayag. That was the system. And after 2 months, again he comes back and he remains home for another 2 months, again goes out. In this way, the whole process is how to give up attachment from the family life, from this world. And when he is trained up fully, he takes sannyas. That is our Vedic system. So, the attachment of this material world is very strong. That is stated in the Srimad Bhagavatam by Rishabde. Pungshan Sriyami Funibhavami Tat. This whole material world is an attachment of male and female. Pungshan Sriya. Mithuni bhava, sex impulse attachment. Tayor mitha hridayaganti mahu. And when they are married, when they are united, then it becomes a hard knot in the heart. Atak vihat chetra sutata vittai janasamohoyam aham mameti. Then gradually, after being united, one becomes attached to griha, home, apartment, kshetra. Formerly there was no industry, so everyone must have some land to produce food. Griha, kshetra, suta, then children, apta, friends, vitta, then money, because without money, nothing can be maintained. Atagriya chetrasutata vittai janasya moha. He becomes more and more illusioned. And aham mameti, this is my country, this is my family, this is my house, this is my children, so on, mama, mine, and I am this person, I am this body. This is illusion. So, Arjuna appeared to be illusion. So how I shall fight with my brothers and grandfather on the other side? He became so much illusion. Tanatathakipayavishtam. He became illusion, not unnecessarily. He was very much compassionate with his family members. Kripayavistam. Astupurna Kulechanam. And he was crying. There was tears in his eyes. Visidantam idam vakram. And he was lamenting in this way. House like fire. So Krishna then began to speak. Krishna saw that my friend Arjuna has become too much illusion. So he wanted to kill the demon of illusion. Therefore he mentioned here it as Madhusudana. Krishna comes. He has got two business. Paritranaya sadhana vinashayata dushkita. Side by side, giving protection to his devotees, sadhu. Sadhu means devotee. Devotee of Krishna is mentioned in the Bhagavad Gita as sadhu. Apite sudurachara bhajate imam ananna bhava. Sadhu reva samanta. One who is strictly a pure devotee of Krishna, he is mentioned as sadhu. Sadhu reva samanta. Sammak vavasita hi sa. He is such class sadhu. Even if he is a grihastha, it doesn't matter. Generally we understand sadhu means with saffron cloth. No. Sadhu's qualification is that he must be a pure devotee of Krishna. Sadhava sadhu bhujana. Sadhava sadhu bhujana. So now Krishna speaks. Sri Bhagavan was. Bhagavan. This Bhagavan means one who is full with six kinds of opulence. He is called Bhagavan. Vaisajyasya, samartasya, vidyasya, jasasya, sriya, jnana, vairagya, chaiva, sarayiti, bhagangana. Bhaga. Bhagavan and Krishna. Krishna means all attractive. Bhagavan Sri Krishna. Krishna Stu Bhagavan Sayam. There are other great personalities. Lord Shiva is also sometimes described as Bhagavan. Similarly, Lord Brahma, Narada, others are also sometimes described as Bhagavan. But real Bhagavan means Krishna. They are Bhagavan partial. All these things have been very much carefully analyzed by Sri Rupa Goswami. He has analyzed in the Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, which we have translated into English, Nectar of Devotion. He has analyzed that Krishna is 10% Bhagavan. And Narayana is 94% Bhagavan. And Lord Shiva is 84%. And all other living entities, all living entities we are minutely 78% Bhagavan. That means when you come to the perfection of life, when you are actually in the spiritual state, then you have got the qualities of Bhagavan in minute quantity, but not all the qualities, 78%. These have been very nicely analyzed. In Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu. And the Shastra says also, Krishnastu Bhagavan Sayam. In the Srimad Bhagavatam, there is a list of all the incarnations. So such and such incarnation appears for such and such particular activities. In that incarnation list, there is name of Lord Ramchandra also, Lord Buddha also. Buddha's name is also there. But in the conclusive portion, it is declared there, Iti Chansakala Pumsa, Krishnastu Bhagavan. In the, at least, the name of Lord Krishna, Lord Balaram is there also. But the conclusion is given by Vyasadeva that except Krishna, all others, they are a plenary expansion of Krishna or part of plenary expansion of Krishna. Aṃsa kala. Aṃsa means direct expansion. And kala means expansion of the secondary expansion. So it is concluded there that iti chansa kala punsa, all these incarnations, they are either aṃsa or kala. But Krishna, the name Krishna, Krishnastu Bhagavan Swayam. He is the original personality of God, Krishna. The same thing here Vyasadeva described, Sri Bhagavan Uvas. He is not ordinary person. Bhagavan speaking. Bhagavan means, what is Bhagavan? Aisarja. Aisarja means riches. Nobody can be richer than Bhagavan. We have got our ideas of richness. I may be rich, but you are richer than me. Somebody is richer than you, somebody is richer than another, another, another. You go, make proceed. When you find out the final richest person, that is Bhagavan. Aishajyasya samagras, all riches. Not that partial. One may have 1,000, another may have 1 lakh, one may have 1 crore, but nobody can say that I have got all the money. No, that is not possible. But Bhagavan has all the money. Aishajyasya samagrasya, bijasya, similarly strength, bodily strength or power. Aishajyasya samagrasya, bijasya, jasasya, and similarly reputation. We are also reputed. But nobody can be reputed than Krishna. Just like 5,000 years ago, he spoke the Bhagavad Gita, and he so reputed that Krishna spoke Bhagavad Gita, and still it is running on, not only in India, but we are traveling all over the world. There are so many editions of Bhagavad Gita. So he so reputed. Kaisajasa Savagasa Bijasa Jasasa Sriya and beautiful. The most beautiful Krishna. Most attractive. Jasasa Jnana, knowledge. Now Krishna's knowledge, there is no limit. Still, the knowledge, the book of knowledge which has given this Bhagavad Gita, there is no comparison. There is no second book in the whole world which contains so full of knowledge. So, jnana and vairagya also. In spite of all the property of Krishna, Krishna doesn't care for this material world. He is busy in the spiritual world. Radha Madhava, Kunya Vihari, he is busy in Vrindavan. He has many servants, this big man has got many secretaries, servants, they look after. Similarly, in this material world, he is representative, Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesha, they are managing the affairs of this whole universe. But he is enjoying and Vrindavan. Jai Radha Madhava Kunya Vihari. He has no concern. He doesn't care what is happening here. But it does not mean that he doesn't care, but he has no anxiety how the things are being managed. When it is mismanaged, then sometimes Krishna comes in his Vasudeva form, not the original Krishna. Original Krishna never leaves Vrindavan. Padamekam nagacchi. He is always in his abode. Chintamani prakara sadmasu kalpa vrikha lakhabritesu suravi ravipalayan lakshmi sahasra sata samrama sevvamanam govindam adipurusam tamaham vajam. He is very much adhere to his cow, Suravi Ravipalan, and is surrounded by hundreds and thousands of goddess of fortune, his gopi. He is surrounded. Lakshmi Sahasra Sata Samrama Sevvamanam. We are praying goddess of fortune to have some favor. But in the spiritual world, Krishna is served by hundreds and thousands of goddess of fortune. This is Krishna's position. So, I do not know why foolish people, they do not understand what is God. Everything is there. And he comes also, personally, not only the God's name, address, activities and everything is there. But he comes personally also. He proves that he is the Supreme Personality of God. When Krishna was present, he proved all these things. Aishat jasya samaktasya, bheed jasya, jasya sastriya. He proved. He had 16,000 wives, and each wife a big palace building of marble, bedecked with jewels and garden with parijat flowers. These are descriptions. Nobody can maintain 16,000 wives in 16,000 palaces. Not only that, not that if he enters in one palace, he lives with one wife, the other wives are better. No. He expanded himself into 16,000 forms. And with each wife was living comfortably. Each wife had 10 children. And those children also had each 10 children, grandsons. In this way, Krishna's family was more than 1 crore, Yadvansha. So, if you study from material point of view, when Krishna was present, he proved that he is Bhagavan. And Bhagavan means not a big beard and meditation. Krishna never became Bhagavan by meditation. He was not a manufactured God. He is God all else. He is not manufactured. When he was on the lap of his mother, Yashoda, he was God. The Putana came to kill him, but Krishna killed him. In this way, if we read the life of Krishna, he is proved Bhagavan. Not only he proved himself, but all other great authorities accepted him Bhagavan. There are 4 Vaishnava acharyas in the recent years, and one Mayavada acharya, Shankaracharya. Shankaracharya also, although he is inclined to the impersonal teacher of the Lord, but he accepted Krishna, Sabhagavan Sayam Krishna. He accepted. Krishna is the Supreme Personality of God, Narayana, Narayana Bhaktya. So, other Vaishnava Acharya, Ramanuja Acharya, Madhyacharya, Vishnu Swami, Nimbarka, lately Lord Chaitanya, all of them accepted Krishna as the Supreme Personality of God. And Arjuna, he also, when he heard from him Bhagavad Gita, he accepted him as the Supreme Personality of God. Parabrahma, Paramdhama, Pavitram, Paramam, Bhavan, Purusham, Shastatam. So Krishna is accepted universally, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Why people are making research, where is God? I do not know. Why they are uselessly taking so much hard labor to search out God? Here is God, Krishna. Bhagavan Vacha. There is no reason, there is no chance of not accepting Krishna as the Supreme Personality of God. Krishna personally says that matta pratam nanya kinchida sti dhananya. There is no more superior element above me. Aham sarvasya prabhava. I am the origin of everything. Aham adi devanam. There are so many statements. Krishna is the Supreme Personality of God. So anyone who is actually serious about understanding about the Supreme Personality of Godhead, there is no difficulty. But because we are obstinate, because we are sinful, because we are lowest of the mankind, because our knowledge has been taken away by Maya, and because we are atheists, we do not accept Krishna as the Supreme Personality. Otherwise there is no reason. Krishna therefore describes Namam Dushkitanam Mura Prapadjante Naradhama. Unless one is Dushkitina, always miscreant, full of sinful life, he cannot deny Krishna as the Supreme Personality of God. This Krishna Consciousness Movement is preaching all over the world that you are all advanced in civilization, and advanced in scientific knowledge, and advanced in everything. But we are missing one thing, God, Krishna. So here is God, here is Krishna. You try to understand Krishna and be Krishna conscious and make your life successful. That is our program. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.